Think one moment what might be the material that you meet more often than any other in your everyday life. In the bags that you carry your shopping, in the bottles that you drink, in the clothes that you wear, in the carpets that you step, in the wheels of your cars, inside your cars, in your electronic appliances, plastic. In 2012, the global production of plastic has arrived close to 300 million tons, whereas 10 years ago, it was 200 million tons, and 20 years ago, it was just 100 million tons. And this is normal, because plastics are amazing materials. They offer all these huge possibilities, they are low cost, and also they are very easily manageable. But when we throw them away, they stay in the environment for 1,000 years, practically forever. And it's not that they just stay there littering. No, they slowly and steadily release toxic chemicals. These chemicals are very small molecules that they can go around, so nowadays they are everywhere. They are in the air that we breathe, they're in the ground, they're in the waters. And what do? They mess up our hormones, causing huge health problems, problems of fertility, problems, neurological problems, immune system problems, cancer. On the top, to make plastics, we need petroleum. The needs in petroleum are increasing continuously every year, not only because of plastics, but also because of other energy needs. And for this reason, the extraction and the transportation of plastic, of petroleum, through tankers, piping systems, and so on, is continuously growing. Unfortunately, during these activities, accidents happen. So nowadays, almost 10 million tons of petroleum can arrive to our seas. Of course, with lethal consequences for any living organism where is the accident. This, but also other activities like the ones that you see, that pollute our environment, are due to technological development and the need of materials well-being. So today, what I want to show you is that we can use technology and material science to help the environment instead of polluting it. What do? Is we use simple objects, like a sponge. Sponges are very interesting objects because they have all these small pores inside them, so they have big exposed surface area, so they can interact very well with the environment. These are the pores of the sponge, the so-called cells, under the electronic microscope. What we do is we modify the walls of these cells by using very small objects, the nanoparticles. The nanoparticles are objects of dimensions 10,000 times smaller than a human hair. So this is the sponge after we have modified its walls with nanoparticles. And why we do this? Because all the properties of the nanoparticles are passing to the sponges. So if we put there magnetic nanoparticles, the sponge becomes magnetic. If we put emitting nanoparticles, the sponge becomes emitting. If we put nanoparticles that they repel the water, the sponge becomes waterproof. I want to show you here an example. This is a simple sponge. We can find it everywhere. But we have modified it inside with nanoparticles that they are magnetic, and at the same time, they absorb oil. Outside, we have modified it with nanoparticles that they repel the water. So this sponge is waterproof. You can see here the water droplets that they are completely repaired, whereas the oil droplets, the one that we have colored blue, they are absorbed very easily into the sponge. Here, we simulate oil spills in the sea. So you can see oil droplets on the water. The foam is on the water because it's floating, because it's water repellent, and we can move it with a simple magnet towards the spill. It is absorbing the petrol, the oil, all the oily substances, and after it has cleaned the water, we can recover it with a simple magnet. After this, we can recover also the oil or the petrol by simple squeezing or by using simple solvents. Next, I want to show you another kind of foam that what we have done is we have modified it inside and outside with nanoparticles that they absorb the toxic heavy metals like mercury, arsenic, cadmium, other pollutants for our waters. This water is polluted with mercury ions. So you can see that we put these ponds inside. And after the real time of this video is 2 minutes, after a couple of minutes, the sponge is changing color because the nanoparticles that they are inside, they are attracting the mercury. So here you can see the sponge on your left hand before any modification. In the middle, after we modified it with the nanoparticles that they absorb the heavy metals. And on the right hand, this sponge has the mercury after it had purified the water. Another thing I want to show you today is how we can use the environment by producing new plastics, new bioplastics. These bioplastics have properties very similar to the synthetic one, so we target in replacing the synthetic plastics. These plastics are coming from the waste of vegetables, so the part of the vegetables that we don't eat and we just throw away. So these plastics are biodegradable, and at the same time, they give a solution to the management of the vegetable waste, because only in Europe, every year, we have 24 million tons of waste of vegetables that the companies, they don't know how to manage. I want to show you how simple is the process. Here you can see different vials with different ways of vegetables. You can see rice, you can see tomato, parsley, and so on. What we do is we use a common solvent for all of them. We put the solvent into the waste, and slowly what the solvent is doing is entering inside the fibers and slowly separating them. So in the end, what is happening is that all the natural polymers that they exist in the vegetables, like the lignin, the cellulose, and so on, they are slowly separating and they swim freely into the solution. After a few hours or days, depending on the vegetable, you can see that the solution is completely homogeneous. And after this, we can pour it into any mold, the solvent is evaporating, and we can get these very nice plastics. So these plastics have exactly the same components as the vegetables, but now they are arranged in a completely different amorphous way. In this way, we can get different kinds of plastics, also because you have to think that we can combine different ways, so we can tune the properties of the plastics. The plastic can be soft, they can be hard, they can be flexible, they can be stiff, they can resist to different solvents, they can absorb or not water. But above all, they don't contain any toxic chemicals, and when we throw them away, after a few weeks, they disappear. They are completely biodegradable. So, the next time that you clean your vegetables, before throwing away the stems or the leaves, take a moment and think that these might be the plastics of the future. Thank you.